not good light, is it? Let's try that again. Good morning, welcome to Monday. It is another Monday. It's a nice Monday today. I'm off to Exeter to meet up with Kirsten on it this morning. 10 past nine now. I'm about to just quickly have a piece of toast and then leave for Exeter because I want to get, we're not meeting until 11, but I want to get there early because I want to film a shop with me in Primark for Friday's video. Thought we'd do that. Not that I'm trying to buy anything from Primark, but I always like to look at what's available. And I know you guys too. You guys do too. You could do too. Yes, I'm missing out words here. Anyway, yeah, that's what I'm doing this morning. Just thought I'd say hello. Having a wander around Marks and Spencer with Kirsten, who's over there, who has just posed the question about this lady who's wearing a jumper, a coat, and a dress, and sandals. Weird. Why would you put sandals on if it's cold enough to need a coat and a jumper on top of your dress? I've just had a good wander around Boots, looking at all the makeup. I have bought nothing. I know, gold star. Kirsten has bought a little at Maybelline 3 for 2. I'm sure she'll show us what she's got. I think we're going to go out for lunch now. Kirsten has just reminded me that I'm vlogging and I forgot. So here is my lunch. It is smoked salmon and cucumber and cream cheese, open sandwich with salad and chips. And Kirsten has got scampi.
Monkfish scampi.
Yes. Is it nice?
It's very nice. It's very
excellent. This is where we are for lunch. It's very nice. It's called Lloyd's Lounge, I think. We are in the shop that is called Oliver Bonas or Bonas. I never know which, but I'm very taken by this little evening bag. I've been looking for a new evening bag for ages. And that is £55. I won't be buying it. Spoiler alert. That is a similar one, but green. And there's a little pearly cream coloured one at the end. They're all lovely, but too expensive. Having a wander around New Look. This is a big two-story New Look store. This rail, this one rail here, is their entire plus size offering. That is very, very poor next. Not next.
New Look.
Very, very poor New Look. You've got to say that again for my vlog. We're talking about knee-high boots. And Kirsten said, I can't wear those because...
because I've got athletic calves. But then I said I can't wear these either because I've got athletic ankles.
Tell me, what are athletic ankles?
Chunky.
I love that. I must have an athletic stomach. John Lewis have not even cleared out their real remnants of Christmas, which I haven't even bothered to film. Real leftovers. But they have got an Easter display up. They're pretty, the little hanging baubles. How much are they? £5, I think. Oh, that's not too bad. They're pretty. We're doing a quick bus stop haul. Kirsten's bought
a hair clip.
Hair clip from Primark.
I bought some. Somebody said that I should buy some curl revitalising thing. So I bought some of that.
Okay. Oh, let me know if that's any good.
Yeah, I will.
I'd quite like
it. For like the next day.
Yes, I heard you talk about that on your video the other day.
Then I've got some mascara.
3 for 2 on Maybelline. Excellent mascara.
Sky High.
Highly recommend.
A concealer.
Excellent concealer. Highly recommend.
And
you've been TikToked.
I don't know if that's the right one though.
Oh right. You'll have to let us know if it's any good.
It's a... can't read it because I haven't got
Superstay 24 hours powder foundation, I think.
Yeah.
It's not my bus, is it? No. Hello. It's Tuesday. It's not Tuesday morning either, it's 5:20 on Tuesday afternoon. I've been in quite a funny mood today. I've been... I've got almost everything done on my to-do list. I didn't sleep well last night. I was up in the night. And I just feel a bit meh. A little bit meh. Quite liking this lighting arrangement I've got going on. I've got ceiling lights over there. And look at no lights over here. And that's working quite well. Anyway, I thought I'd better turn the camera on and just say hi and prove I'm still alive on Tuesday. And I thought I'd show you some bits that I bought. I have been trying to do a low buy, as you know, and internet wise it's gone pretty well. It has been quite in fact I don't think I've bought anything other than the clothes for New Look, the New Look haul that you saw, which I didn't buy. I was sent a gift voucher for those. I don't think I've bought anything on the internet for me this month. Householdy bits maybe, but yeah, I don't think I've bought anything since the beginning of the year, which is good because I had developed a little bit of a internet shopping habit, as I've touched upon before. Anyway, Ashley and I went to Torquay last Friday night. I think I mentioned that already. We went for a meal at a really nice restaurant and we got a £37 a night hotel room. Absolute bargain. Hotel on the seafront as well. That was nice. And on the Saturday morning, there's a local department store in Torquay, an independent one, and it had its January sale finishing on the Saturday, and we saw a sign on the Friday night in the window saying that everything that was in the sale was being reduced by 50% off its lowest reduced price, and they sell some lovely brands in there, some nice handbags. Didn't buy any. So we wanted to go and have a look at that. Ashley was quite keen to look at the menswear, and he got a couple of bits in there. And I got one thing. Bear with me, let me show you. Spoiler alert, it's candles. But I couldn't leave them behind at this price. So it is a box set of neon candles. Love a box set. Looks like that. Oh my God, the smell as I open them. It's the Christmas box set of candles, and that's what they look like. And we have, I'm going to peer at them now. Tell you what, I'll just get glasses, because nobody, the internet does not need me peering at things that I can't see, especially as I'm in the dark, although it looks like I'm in the light in the camera. So we've got this one, which is called Christmas Wish. Oh, gorgeous. Does it say what it's... Doesn't say the scent notes, but it's lovely. That one is Perfect Peace, that's called. That is metallic, so it's not going to show up too well. And this orange one, oh, that smells like fire, by the fireside. That smells like, it's called Cozy Nights. I don't know if that's focusing or not. But aren't they lovely? Now, originally, that set was £45. And then its lowest price in the sale was £31.50. But it was half of that. So it was £15.75 for the candle set. I think I've worked that out correctly. It was £15 something anyway. So yeah, very, very happy with that set of candles, neon candles for £15.75. I could not leave it behind. And as I said, didn't go too mad with them. All the lovely stuff that was in there, some beautiful Radley handbags and Michael Kors and all sorts of lovely bits and pieces. Anyway, that shop didn't open till 10 o'clock. So we were wandering around. I went for a walk up the seafront and had breakfast and coffee. And then we had a wander around town and we popped into TK Maxx. Can't pop into TK Maxx without buying something, can you? I can't, anyway. I picked up this beautiful glass Turkish bowl. It's a flower and it's sort of matte on the outside and then shiny on the inside. I don't know what sort of flower it's supposed to be, but isn't that absolutely beautiful? The brand is, I don't know if you can see that, Akkam, and it's from Turkey. I have looked it up, I haven't found out too much about it. But I don't know if you saw the price sticker on that. That bowl was £7.99. I couldn't leave it behind. I thought it was so beautiful. I don't know what I'm going to do with it either. I do have, one of my bedrooms is decorated in purpley colours. But it might go down in the new entrance hall, I'm thinking, on the sideboard. I don't know, but I could not leave that beautiful bowl behind for £7. I mean, because it's... shiny on the inside, it's glass. You could use it as a salad bowl, couldn't you? You could use that as a salad bowl in the summer or in the winter, but we don't use a lot of salad in the winter. But yes, I just thought that was lovely. And then I bought another candle, but hear me out on this. It's a sand and fog candle. A lot of the TK Maxx and HomeSense candles are by this brand. I believe it's an American brand. Am I right with that? Yes, I am right about that. And this is guava and mango. But the main reason I bought this was for the lid, which has Happy Spring written on it. It's a wooden lid. And you know I have my little table display here. Oh, can you see that? Yes, my circular table. God, that's the worst bit of photography I've ever done. My little circular table display, which I update with the seasons. It's still on winter at the moment. I thought that would be a lovely sign to put in as part of my spring display. And the candle was sort of a bonus with it. The candle was $9.99. Sure, these used to be $7.99 in TK Maxx. Actually, it wasn't. It was $8.99. I tell a lie, it was $8.99. Smells absolutely glorious. I love a fruity candle. But yeah, it has this, which will last forever and I can use as part of my spring display on an ongoing basis once I've used the candle up. So those were my little purchases. Anyway, nothing else exciting going on here. We've got shepherd's pie out of the freezer for dinner tonight that I made previously. And yeah, quiet night. We haven't got anything to watch at the moment. We just finished Kaleidoscope, which was very good. I'm going to talk more about that in Friday. I'm going to do a little TV recommendations in the Friday chat, probably. Actually, you'll probably have seen it by the time you see this, because these ones work 2 weeks behind. Anyway, I'm just waffling now, so I'm going. Good morning. It's the 1st of February. We all got through January. We should pat ourselves on the back for that, for sure. Absolutely. Yeah, Wednesday, 1st of February. The sun was shining. It's not quite so much anymore. But I've got the patio door open. There is definitely a little bit of warmth in the air, which is lovely. So I'm just having my coffee, which I have here. It's mid-morning coffee, but it's 11:30 because I'm late as usual. And just enjoying some fresh air. Going to read a little bit. I'm reading The Four Winds by Kristen Hannah, which is very good so far. Recommend. Yes, drink my coffee, sit and enjoy the February fresh air, and try and think about happy things. Struggling a little bit this week, but never mind. These things are sent to try us, aren't they? I have just hung laundry. I have just hung laundry on the washing line outside. And I cannot tell you what a little spark of joy it gave me inside. I don't think it's going to dry properly, but there's a little bit of a breeze, so it might dry a little bit before I have to bring it in and hang it over the rail here. But yeah, little bit of joy that was. A little bit of springtime joy. I know I've touched upon this subject before, but I really do think that food manufacturers need to do better with accessible packaging. I mean, accessibility in terms of being able to get into places and disability, you know, wheelchair ramps and alternatives to stairs and all of that sort of thing have been improving over the last few years, without a doubt. But for example, this cheese has a little tab here which you are supposed to be able to pull the top off to open it. It doesn't work. It never works on this particular type of cheese, which is as does Gran Padano, if anybody cares. But I find it a lot with food packaging, and I am a perfectly able-bodied person with perfect motor skills. There are so many people who have arthritic fingers or, you know, all sorts of problems. And manufacturers really need to bloody sort this and other food packaging out. There is a lot of inherent problems with packaging not opening as it's supposed to. And I think that it's lagging way behind in terms of accessibility for all. And that's just my little rant for today. My soup's probably finished microwaving now, so I'll go get it. It's 6:15, something like that, and I've had an adminy and sorting day. Still in the kitchen, still doing the cupboards. Honestly, I'm making heavy weather of it, to be honest, but I've done up to there. I've just done that one, so I've just got the corner one and this one to do, and then the bottom ones around here tomorrow. So I'm going to try and get those last two done this evening. Now I've just got that one and those two. I feel like it's taken me the whole of January and now we're into February to do these cupboards, and heartily sick a bit if I'm honest, but it's a good job done. I'm enjoying getting organised and sorted. Good morning, it is Thursday. I've been awake since 4:30, I think. So I'm going to crash this afternoon, but I'm trying to have a really productive morning and get stuff done so that when I crash, I feel like entitled to crash because I've got stuff done. So I've just pulled out one of the last kitchen cupboards. I'm really hoping to get them all but finished today, or but completely finished by tomorrow anyway. I've done some admin-y bits. I need to do a couple of letters regarding my flat that I rent out. And I'm about to film a video, a try-on video, which you will have seen by the time you see this. That's the pile of clothes. And trying to get a little bit ahead of myself for next week, because, bear with, I'm just going to strap you onto the tripod. That's the word I'm looking for, and I'll be back. There we are. Let's pull you up a little bit. Yeah, we're away for a couple of days next week, so I'm trying to get a little bit ahead of myself with filming. Anyway, I need to have a little bit of a rant before we start about something I heard on the news this morning, which was that apparently Welsh rugby have banned Tom Jones's song Delilah from being played at rugby matches. Or well, someone's banned it anyway, I don't know who. And choirs can't sing it either. Now, correct me if I'm wrong here. But okay, the song is about a man killing his wife, essentially. There are any number of songs in the history of the world about nasty violent acts, aren't there? What's the one about Lola who was a showgirl? Isn't that a bloke killing a woman, or a woman killing a bloke, or someone killing someone anyway? Surely it shouldn't matter who's killing who. But the Bohemian Rhapsody, I mean, it's just also, side note, or not even a side note, also, they literally make computer games for teenagers where the premise of the game is that you are a person with multiple guns running riot round a random town, killing all sorts of people, literally shooting random people. If that's not ridiculously violent, I don't know what is. Surely that should be banned rather than a song from the 60s. I don't know what this world is coming to. Political correctness and wokeness is just, has just gone mad. Stop the bloody bus, I want to get off. Anyway, I should probably stop ranting. But yes, really, the world has gone mad. Proper mad. Well, I've had quite a productive morning. It's about 1:15. Side note, how do birds poo down a vertical window? How does that happen? I mean, that takes some skill, surely. Not like I can pop outside and wipe it off with a cloth, is it? Heavens. And it's not, it happens quite regularly. Even if there's some on the next window as well. I don't know how well you can see that on that window, but yeah, absolutely ridiculous. I mean, that must take some skill level. I bought, do you remember this pink jumper that I bought recently from George at Asda? I've worn it maybe four times, I think. Look at the state of it. I mean, I suppose you buy cheap jumpers, you expect that, really. But really, not more than four times. It started doing it the first, sorry, it's not easy to see. Because of the sun, in fact, it might be easier to see in the sun. But it's really bad, that. I feel like I've just had a go at it with the fabric shaver. You know, the little, can't remember what they're called, but fabric shaver thing. And because of the way it's peeled, it hasn't taken it off. It's everything that's, it's not really peeling. It's more sort of just rubbing, and it's quite hard to pull it off, and the fabric shaver doesn't seem to want to take it off very easily at all. Just a bit poor, isn't it? Because I can't really wear it in that state. I can, but it doesn't look very nice. Oh, irritating. Anyway, I suppose don't buy jumpers from Georgia Asda is the cure for that, isn't it? I've done very well this morning. I have cleaned and cleared and sorted this roundy, roundy cabinet here. Let me just close that one. And this one here, I've also done. That's so super empty now. It looks fuller than it actually is. The bottom shelf is almost completely empty. And I'm just going to have a go at this one before I have my lunch. And yeah, that'll be a very good job done. Then I've only got the drawers, which really just need the stuff pulling out and cleaning and putting back in. They're fairly tidy. And then we will come round to these ones here. Oh my goodness, I'm feeling quite... It's such a nice feeling, isn't it, getting stuff organised? And I'm looking forward to moving on to elsewhere in the house. This has become a major project, it feels like. It's 5:10. God, my roots look shocking in this light. 5:10, I said that already. And I am... Shut the curtains. I am going out this evening to meet up with my best friend for food and wine. We haven't had a night out since before Christmas. It's not really a night out, actually. We move home by 9 o'clock usually. But it'd be really nice to catch up with her. We have seen them once before since Christmas, but that was sort of the four of us. So I haven't seen her by myself for a while. So I'm looking forward to that. Got my kitchen done. Apart from the two cupboards, one above the oven and one below with tins and cookery stuff in there. But I've got all the food cupboards done and all the drawers on that side. So it was a major blooming job and it was long overdue a clear out. So very happy about that. Now, I'm thinking I need to have a shower and wash my hair to brighten myself up for going out this evening, because I didn't have a nap this afternoon despite being awake since 4:30 this morning. I finished my book instead, and I am feeling absolutely exhausted. So I thought, oh, I'll have a shower and wash my hair, and then I thought that'll mean taking makeup off and starting it all over again, and I don't think I've got it in me. I'm gonna force myself. But honestly, because I know I will feel better. I know that if I take my makeup off, have a shower, wash my hair, dry it, put some nice clothes on, I will feel so much better than I feel at the moment. And yes, that's what I'm going to do. But I'm having to fight myself with every fibre of my being to make myself do it. I'll be back when I've improved what I look like. I've decided to go the whole nine yards. Doing a face mask. It's a peel mask, actually. It's the ordinary AHA and BHA peel. I've used this for years. Really, really good. Use it once a week. Actually, that's not true. I was in the habit of using it once a week and then I stopped. You don't want to leave it on for more than about 10 minutes. And if you have sensitive skin, maybe don't recommend. But my skin's like rhinoceros hide, frankly. But it's pretty good for giving you back a little bit of glow. And then I'm going to go in the shower, wash my hair and do a body scrub with my scrubby gloves and this Sephora Brown Sugar, I think it's called, scrub. Haven't used this one yet. This is a new one which I'm opening today. It smells delicious. So yeah, I thought I'd go the whole nine yards. Right, while I wait for the 10 minutes to be up, I'm going to catch up with something on YouTube, I think. And I am ready for the evening, feeling a lot better, as I knew I would. I've got this top on, which was from New Look a little while ago, with the, don't know how well you can see that, the sort of animal print sparkly heart on the front. Simply Be black straight leg jeans, which you've seen a million times before. And these little Chelsea boots, which were originally Marks & Spencer's via Vinted, which you've also seen a million times before. Let's go and pick some earrings. As I don't have any on, I'm going to put a long grey cosy cardigan on as well, because it's chilly. Let me just pop you up on that shelf. I'll get you back in a minute. Just let me put these away. And then I will pick out. So this is where I keep my earrings. I've shown you this before, I'm sure. Just inside the wardrobe door. It's like a plastic thingy that is screwed on. I think it came from Amazon. I will link it below in case anybody's interested. Do you know what? I'm going to have these big dangly silver ones this evening. Yes, excellent. Those are the ones I'm going to wear. I'm going to recommend two hair products as well that I have been using for... Oh, I don't know if I've ever talked about them. I think I might have talked about one of them. But I've been using them for probably the best part of a year now, I would say. Let me put these earrings in. Finished my book earlier on, the Kristen Hanna one, which I really super much enjoyed. It was called The Four Winds, I think I showed you. Oh, the black bit has just come off that one. That is not good. However, at least it came off in my hand. Is it going to clip back in? No, that's going to need some glue. That's annoying. I'm going to go and choose some other earrings now. Bear with. Actually, I'm not, because I've got some here that I can put on. Just use the back from that one. I'm going to have these little golden marble ones. They're already out. That is the height of laziness, isn't it? Save me getting up and going to the cupboard again. I'm just going to put these ones on because they're out. Honestly, so lazy. Apologies for the hideous light, by the way. Right, hair products. One super cheap, one a bit more expensive. This stuff, VO5, super cheap. It is volume blow dry, full of life, and it says it lifts roots and adds body, and it definitely does. I don't think this does an awful lot when I dry my hair straight. I use a different product when I dry it straight, as I've had it all week. But when I want to dry it with a bit of volume and sort of some waves and a bit more bouncy, this is the one. Very good. I like it a lot. I will link that one below as well. And then this is bloody brilliant for anyone who's got limp, thin hair. When I wash my hair, I literally can't do anything with it. If it wasn't for these products, it would be hopeless. If I back comb a bit on the top to pull up like this, it would just fall out if I didn't have this. It is called Cool Girl Hair by Sam McKnight. Barely There Texture Mist. This is sort of a hybrid between a texturising spray and a hairspray. And it's absolutely brilliant. It's not cheap. It's about £20, I think. But this has lasted me absolutely ages. Because it's expensive, I use it sparingly. And I lift this bit of hair up when I've dried. Well, I rough dry my hair, scrunch dry it, and then I like to put a bit of height into this bit. I lift this bit up and I literally give it a tiny spray on the front, a tiny spray on the back, and then back comb it. And it stays in just perfectly. If I didn't do that, it would be absolutely hopeless. And it would, even with the back combing, it would just come out. It's too soft and pliable, my hair. And then just put a few little squirts of this in all the way around, just to keep it bouncy and a bit of body in it. It's just brilliant, and it brushes out quite easily as well. Highly, highly, highly recommend. I will link both of those below. I'm going to start a new book, The Appeal by Janice Hallett, which I've heard good things about. I'm looking forward to it. And, oh, it's 6:30. I will need to go out soon because I'm going to go and drop parcels on the way to meeting my friend. So, yeah, I will see you again tomorrow. Well, just like that, Friday has rolled around again. Oh, do you know, I've got really dry hands. I need to put some hand cream on them. Can you hear that? It sounds like paper, doesn't it? Anybody else get really dry body skin in the winter? Do find that I really struggle with it. Anyway, spring is on the way. Got some tulips this morning. Let me show you my tulips before I disappear for the week. Remember, I was having a moan last week about how expensive tulips were in Tesco's. Got these ones in Aldi this morning. This one's having a little droop. I've got my 2p in there, so I hope it's not going to droop too much. £3.89 for this bunch in Aldi. They're still quite tight, so they should last for several days, hopefully. Just pop those down there. Had a really nice evening out with my best friend last night. We caught up and chatted and put the world to rights and had some nice food and some wine and, yeah, all good. Today I have been just working and finishing off the kitchen. I think I've just got a few bits to put back in one cupboard and the kitchen is done. Yay, go me. Then I've got to decide what I'm moving on to next. I think I said that yesterday, didn't I? Anyway, yeah, that's a good job done. I'm glad that kitchen is finished. Today is William's birthday, 3rd of February. He's 23 years old. How have I got a child who's 23? I can't quite get my head around it. It's only 10 minutes ago that he was 3, surely. Anyway, I think that is it for this week. Next week it's going to be a bit of a change. It's a travel vlog next week. We're going away for a couple of days. Part one will be on Wednesday and then there'll be normal Friday chat on Friday, I think. And actually, I can't remember. I'm working too far ahead of myself here because you'll see this next at the end of next week, so can't remember, but I think part one's due on Wednesday and part two is due on Sunday of my little travel vlog, so hopefully you'll enjoy that. Hope you've enjoyed this week's. Thank you very much for watching and I will see you again soon. Bye bye.